الصدق وضده الكذب، لأن المنافق نسأل الله عليه السلام عندما يقول لا إله إلا الله هو كاذب ليس بصادق.
And then the third condition of لا إله إلا الله is to be truthful. They have to be truthful when you are saying لا إله إلا الله, and its opposite is lying.
أيضا اليقين يعني موقن 100% أن الله سبحانه وتعالى هو المفرد بأنواع التوحيد الثلاثة، وموقن 100% أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هو عبد لا عبد ورسول لا كذب عليه الصلاة والسلام، وضد اليقين الشك. نعم.
And then the fourth condition of لا إله إلا الله is اليقين. And اليقين means that you have to have 100% certainty that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you have to have 100% certainty, yaqeen, that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is the messenger of Allah, and therefore he should not be rejected, and he is the worshipper of Allah, and then therefore he should not be worshipped.
نعم. والمحبة وضدها البغض. لابد أن يحب الله سبحانه وتعالى ولا يحب أحد مع الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And then the fifth condition of لا إله إلا الله is المحبة. And this is love. Meaning that a person has to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that your love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to be pure. Such that you do not love anything equal to your love of Allah subhanahu
wa ta'ala. طيب أين محبة الأنبياء والرسل عليهم الصلاة والسلام مثلا؟
And if a person was to ask, what about the love of the prophets and the messengers?
نحبهم في الله، لكن لا يمكن أن تكون محبتهم مساوية لمحبة الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And the answer is that we love the prophets and messengers for the sake of Allah. But even your love of the prophets and the messengers cannot be equal to your love of Allah.
والقبول وضده الرد. لابد أن من يقول لا إله إلا الله يقبل كل ما جاء في الكتاب والسنة، ما يرد حرف واحد. نعم.
And then the next condition of لا إله إلا الله is القبول. And al-qubul means acceptance, meaning when you say la ilaha illallah, you have to accept everything which is in the Quran and the Sunnah, and you're not allowed to reject a single harf, a single letter from the Quran.
ولا بد من الانقياد، لا بد من العمل، يعمل بالشريعة ولا يترك العمل. نعم.
And also the next condition of la ilaha illallah is al-inqiyad. And al-inqiyad means you have to comply to la ilaha illallah. You have to act upon la ilaha illallah.
نعم. وثم من شروط لا إله إلا الله أن تكفر بجميع ما يعبد من دون الله.
And then from the conditions of لا إله إلا الله is الكفر. Meaning you have to reject and disbelieve in everything which is worshipped besides Allah.
نعم. فإذا تحققت هذه الشروط يفتح لك.
So when a person says لا إله إلا الله fulfilling all of these conditions, then the door of Jannah is open for this person.
نعم. طيب الشرك عندنا ينقسم إلى شرك أكبر وشرك أصغر.
And after this shirk, this is divided into two categories: major shirk, shirk al-akbar, and minor shirk, shirk al-asghar.
نريد أمثلة على الشرك الأكبر.
And we want examples regarding shirk akbar.
ماشي. اترك الكتاب يا استاذ. خليكم معي. ها.
So who can give me
على الشرك الأكبر؟
Who can give me an example of shirk akbar, major shirk?
عبادة الأصنام.
Like for example, worshipping the idols.
عبادة الجن.
Worshipping jinn.
نعم.
Examples of shirk akbar.
الطواف على القبور.
الطواف حول القبور.
Making tawaf or circumambulating around the
graves.
And also slaughtering animals for jinn or slaughtering animals in the name of the deceased.
كل عبادة تصرف لغير الله شرك أكبر.
Any type of ibadah which is directed to other than Allah, this is shirk akbar.
طيب أمثلة على الشرك الأصغر.
Who can give examples for shirk asghar, minor shirk?
الرياء. يصلي حتى يقال عنه انه مصلي. نعم.
الرياء meaning showing off, like for example a person who prays, so it can be said regarding him that he is a مصلي.
يا اخوان لا تقروا الكتب.
Brothers, if you close the books, leave the books.
نعم. الحلف بغير الله.
And also swearing by other than Allah, taking an oath by other than Allah.
ما يحلف إلا بالله.
A Muslim should not take an oath except by Allah.
نعم. طيب وغيره.
Any other examples of shirk أصغر minor shirk?
يقول لولا الله وفلان. الأصل يقول لولا الله وحده أو لولا الله ثم فلان. نعم.
If a person said, had it not been for Allah and you, had it not been for Allah and you, and this is also minor shirk because the asl is that a Muslim says, had it not been for Allah alone, or a Muslim can say, had it not been for Allah and then after him you.
Now, إذا يعتقد ويجعل ما لم يجعل الله سبحانه وتعالى سبب سببه يضع مثلا على السيارات على البيوت نعل قديمة أو حافر الفرس نعم. يعتقد أنها سبب وليست سبب هذا شرك أصغر.
And another example of شرك أصغر is if a person believes in a cause which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not make a cause. For example, nowadays people hang old shoes on their cars or their houses or a shoe horse. And they believe that this shoe horse or this old shoe, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings protection through it. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not make this a valid cause, this is shirk al-asghar.
نعم. طيب. عندنا أيضا أقل من الشرك الأصغر الكبائر.
And then a level lower than minor shirk is kabair, the major shirks, the major sins.
وأقل من الكبائر الصغائر.
And lower than the major sins or the minor sins.
إذا عندنا يا أخي خليه أترك هذا أترك.
Close the book. Everything's in the book, so no writing, no reading, no mobile phones, put everything away.
تمام. تمام. صغائر.
So we have صغائر the minor sins.
كبائر.
Then we have كبائر the major sins.
شرك أصغر.
Then we have شرك أصغر which is minor shirk.
شرك أكبر.
And then we have شرك أكبر which is major shirk.
هذه المحرمات.
And these are the محرمات, the actions which are حرام.
أنا ليس لي أن أحرم وأحلل.
And it isn't my right to make something حرام or حلال.
من الذي يحرم ويحلل؟
Meaning it isn't my right to forbid something or to permit something. Who is the one who makes something حرام or حلال?
من?
Who?
نعم. إذا ما يمكن أن أقول حرام وحلال إلا بدليل من الكتاب والسنة الصحيحة. تمام؟
So it's not allowed for a person to say something is haram or halal without an evidence from the Quran and the Sunnah.
لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى هو الرب.
Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is a Rabb.
وأنت عبد.
And as for you, you are the slave of Allah.
نعم. وهذه العبودية لك فيها عزة لله سبحانه وتعالى. العبودية إذا إنسان قال أنا عبد لله هذه العبودية فيها عزة رفع لك. نعم.
And when a person says that I am an abd of Allah, I am a slave of Allah or a worship of Allah, this is an honor for you.
لكن لو خرج الإنسان من هذه العبودية قال أنا حر مثلا وأنا أصنع اللي أريد وهذه حرية. نعم.
However, if a person removes himself from submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he says that I don't want to worship, I want to be free.
نعم. يقول أنا حر.
If a person says that I am not in submission to Allah, I am free.
لا. هذا اللي يقول أنه حر هو في الحقيقة عبد عند الشيطان.
And this is not freedom because the one who thinks he is free from submission to Allah, in reality he is a slave to Shaytan.
الحرية الحقيقية أن تكون عبدا لله تتحرر من الشيطان من النفس من الهوى وتطيع من الله لأن الله أدرى بما يصلح لك هذه الحرية الحر هو الذي يطيع الرب سبحانه وتعالى. نعم.
True freedom is in submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That a person does not look towards shaytan or the desires of his own self or anybody else. Rather, he frees himself from the shackles of everything else to the freedom of worshipping and submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
إذا لابد أن العبد يطيع الرب سبحانه وتعالى.
And therefore, a person has to submit himself to and obey الرب, the Lord.
نعم. فإذا أطاع العبد الرب حصل له كل خير واندفع عنه كل شر.
And if a person obeys الرب, the Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all goodness will be attained by him and all harm will be removed from him.
نعم. الله سبحانه وتعالى ذكر عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه عليه الصلاة والسلام قال وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم.
الله سبحانه وتعالى he described the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he said the meaning of which is verily you O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم you are upon lofty manners.
فيقول لك بعض الناس
And so some people say to you,
يعني غير مسلم يقول لك أنت مسلم.
A non-Muslim might say to you that you are a Muslim.
ما هي أخلاق المسلم؟
So he says to you that you are a Muslim. Tell me about the manners and the characteristics of a Muslim.
نعم. من يعرف أخلاق المسلم؟
So who knows the أخلاق of a Muslim?
نعم.
The one who is tongue and hand. The Muslims are not harmed.
ما شاء الله. يقول المسلم من سلم الناس من لسانه ويده. هذا المسلم يعني باللسان لا يسب لا يشتم يتكلم بالأخلاق بالآداب وكذلك لا يبطش بيده. تمام. هذا المسلم. تمام. تمام.
So a Muslim is somebody whom the other people feel safe from his tongue and from his hands. Meaning, a Muslim tongue does not insult and swear. And a Muslim hand does not violate and harm.
نعم. إذا معنى هذا أن المسلم لا يلعب لا يسب لا يشتم لا يرفع الصوت. نعم.
Meaning, a Muslim does not curse, swear, insult or raise his voice.
نعم.
Honest Islam.
Honest?
Yeah, he's proud of his religion.
يعني يفتخر بالدين الإسلام.
المسلم لابد أن يعرف أن عزة المسلم في الانتماء للإسلام. نعم.
A Muslim should know and understand that his honor is in being connected to Islam.
عندنا مثلا وإن كان في شيء أكرمكم الله حمار.
We have an example. And perhaps it's not entirely right to say it, but for example, you have a donkey at Ramakumullah.
ماذا يصنع؟
And this donkey, what does it do?
يصيح بأعلى صوته. صح ولا؟
The donkey, it makes a sound with the highest pitch of its
voice. ولا عنده إشكال.
And a donkey has no shyness in making this sound.
وهو أكرمكمullah بهيمة. صح؟
And it is أكرمكمullah an animal.
فأنت مسلم.
But you are a Muslim.
ما تصيح تقول أنا مسلم؟
نعم.
يعني ما تصيح تقول للناس أنا مسلم؟
And you're a Muslim, so why don't you, with your loudest voice, tell people that you're Muslim?
ما تفتخر؟
Why do you not feel proud of being a Muslim?
صح أو لا؟
True or not?
المسلم في المعتقد لا يوافق اليهود والنصارى.
So a Muslim in his beliefs. Does not agree with the Yahud and Nasara.
نعم. ولا يوافق في اللباس.
And neither does a Muslim, in terms of his clothing and appearance, dress like a Yahud and
Nasara. ولا في مكان العبادة.
And also in terms of where you worship, you don't conform to a Yahud and Nasara.
اليهود لا مثل النصارى.
The Jews are they like the Christians?
لا.
No.
في الهيئة مثله.
In dress and appearance, do they appear as Christians? No.
لا في اللباس لا في مكان العبادة.
And when it comes to the places in which they worship, do the Jews do it in the same place where the Christians
لا.
worship? No.
في الاعتقاد.
In beliefs, are the Jews similar to the Christians in belief? No.
إذا لابد أيضا أن يكون المسلم والمسلمة في الاعتقاد وفي اللباس وفي الكلام وفي كل شيء غير اليهود والنصارى.
And therefore, also the Muslim man and the Muslim woman, in terms of belief, appearance, how you dress, how you speak, has to be different from al-Yahud wal-Nasar.
نعم. يقول أن من أخلاق المسلم تبسمك في وجه أخيك صدقة. نعم.
And also from the etiquette of the mannerisms of a Muslim is to always be smiling and jovial with your brother.
لو تبتسم في وجه أخيك هذا صدقة.
And if you smile in the face of your brother, then this is a form of charity.
وعرف يقول أهل الإسلام بهذا أنهم يعني راضين بقضاء الله وقدره. ما عندهم يعني بكاء لطم. نعم.
And people know this regarding the people of Islam, that the Muslims, they are pleasing and accepting of the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so they do not weep or tear their clothes or hit themselves.
نعم من أخلاق المسلم الصدق.
Also from the manners and the etiquettes of a Muslim is truthfulness.
يصدق مع من؟
And you should be truthful to whom?
يصدق أولا مع الله.
Firstly, you have to be truthful with Allah.
ثم يصدق مع عباد الله.
And then after this, you should be truthful with the people, the worshippers of Allah.
حتى مع الكفار؟
Even the kuffar.
نعم.
نعم even the كفار.
لا بد يصدق مع الكفار كما كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الكفار يقول عنه الصادق الأمين.
You have to be truthful with the kuffar, just like the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was truthful with the kuffar. And this reason, and for this reason, the kuffar they used to call the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم الصادق الأمين, the truthful one and the trustworthy one.
الأمان.
And also trustworthiness.
إذا من أخلاق هذا الإسلام إيش؟ الأمان.
And so from the qualities and the traits of the people of Islam is الأمانة, trustworthiness.
حتى مع الكفار.
Even with the kuffar.
نعم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عند الهجرة أراد يقتلوه عليه الصلاة والسلام, اجتمع عليه وأموال قريش أمانة عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, فوضع عليه رضي الله عنه حتى يرجع الأمانات لأصحابه لأنه الأمين.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he was making hijrah, when he was migrating, the Quraysh, they wanted to kill and assassinate the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the wealth of the Quraysh, it was with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam because they had given it to him as a trust. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he allowed Ali radiallahu anhu to remain behind. So after he has left, Ali radiallahu anhu can return the deposits and the trust of the Quraysh back to them. Why? Because he was al-Amin, the trustworthy one.
إذن عندنا من يقول في هذه الأيام يصح أن تسرق الكفار وتتحايل عليهم.
Nowadays, amongst the Muslims, there are some people who say and believe that you can steal from the kuffar and you can cheat and deceive the kuffar.
يصح.
Is this correct?
صحيح هذا أو باطل؟ باطل مخالف لما كان عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الصحابة الله سبحانه وتعالى أمر بأداء الأمانة إلى أهلها.
And this is false and incorrect. And this is opposing to what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was upon. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى orders us to repay the people and fulfill their trusts.
نعم. قال أدي الأمانة إلى من ائتمنك ولا تخن من خانك.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, repay the trust to the one who has given you a trust and do not behave treacherously towards the one who was treacherous towards you.
نعم.
أكل الحلال.
ما شاء الله. ماذا؟ تأخر ويتكلم.
Don't be late and talk.
مشكلة. تعالوا. ممنوع الكلام.
Not allowed to talk.
شوف يجعل عقوبة إن شاء الله تعالى. اللي يستخدم التلفون أو كذا عقوبة تأخذ الهاتف من عنده.
ترجع. والله أحسن. تأخذ زي السعودية نعم.
شيخ his suggestion is that punish the people who are late, that take their phones. شيخ نقول صادق في الأمر.
عفوا آخر. نعم. يقول إيش؟
أكل الحلال.
المسلم لا يأكل إلا حلال.
The brother said that from the qualities of a Muslim is only eating halal. A Muslim only eats halal.
لا يأكل ميتة.
So he does not eat an animal which has not been slaughtered.
ولا خنزير.
Neither does a Muslim consume pork.
ولا كلاب.
Neither dogs.
ولا حمير.
Donkeys.
نعم لا يأكل إلا الطيبات. طيب. ولا يأكل خبائث نعم.
And also a Muslim does not eat dirty things like insects. A Muslim only eats that which is طيب, good and pure.
ولا يشرب المخدرات ولا المسكرات ولا الخمر. نعم.
And a Muslim does not take drugs, intoxicants, does not drink alcohol.
نعم. أخلاق المسلم.
Another quality or trait of a Muslim.
تمام. المسلم لا يتعدى على الكافر.
A Muslim does not transgress or violate a non-Muslim.
وأيضا لا يجعل الكافر يتعدى عليه. نعم.
But at the same time, a Muslim does not allow a non-Muslim to violate and transgress against him.
نحافظ على حقوقنا. نعم.
So a Muslim protects the rights of the people.
نعم. نعم. يقول غض البصر.
And also from the qualities and the manners of a Muslim is to control and lower the gaze, the sight.
لماذا؟
Why?
لأن البصر نعمة.
Because this sight is a blessing.
والكفار ينظر إليكم.
And the kuffar, the non-Muslims are looking at you.
نعم. هل تنظر أو لا تنظر؟
They're noticing whether you look or you don't look.
هل تتكلم عن النساء أو لا؟
Do you speak with women or do you not speak with women?
نحن في بريطانيا كيف لا نتكلم عن النساء؟
And if a person says, but we live in Britain, why should we talk to women?
هناك في بريطانيا من المسلمين من لا يتكلم عن النساء إلا في الضرورة الضرورة.
There are people in Britain, Muslims in Britain, who don't speak with women unless it's an absolute necessity.
حتى لو كانت معه ولا ينظر إليها ينزل بصره هكذا.
And there are Muslims in Britain that if a woman appears in front of him, he looks down.
هذه دعوة.
And this in of itself is دعوة.
صحيح. لأن المرأة تعرف أن هذا ينظر ويتكلم وهذا هكذا يمشي. صحيح. مسلم.
And this is دعوة because women they know those men who look and talk, and they know those Muslim men who are straight up like this.
نعم. إذا المسلم لا يخلو بالأجنبية.
And therefore a Muslim does not freely intermingle and mix with a non-related woman.
يغض البصر.
He lowers his eyesight.
لا يتكلم إلا عند الضرورة.
He only speaks with them if there's a need or a necessity.
وإذا تكلم لا يلين بالكلام.
لا.
لا يلين.
And when a Muslim speaks to a woman, he does not flirt with the woman.
أتكلم جاد.
Rather, he is serious in speech.
ما أتكلم أقول.
So he doesn't flirt with the woman.
مفهوم هذا. لا داعي نشرح. صحيح. حتى المرأة المسلمة ما تتكلم عن أجانب ولا تخلو بهم.
And also the Muslim woman, she should not be talking with non-related men to her or freely intermingle with men.
لا يسمع أيضا الحرام.
And also a Muslim does not listen to that which is haram.
لا يسمع الغنى.
Does not listen to music.
لا يسمع الغيبة.
Does not listen to backbiting.
لا يسمع النميمة.
Does not listen to slandering and lying.
مفهوم؟ ما يسمع. ما يسمع إلا الحلال. تمام.
A Muslim only listens to that which is permitted.
وغيره.
Anything else?
نعم. ما شاء الله. من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر قال فليقل خيرا أو يصمت.
Also from the manners and the traits of a Muslim is that whoever believes in Allah and the final day, let him speak with goodness or remain silent.
يعني إما أن تقول كلام خير أو أسكت.
Meaning either you say a word which is good or remain silent.
طيب كلام لا خير ولا شر تقول.
And what if they speak which is neither good nor bad?
لا لا يقول أبدا.
Even this speech you abandon it.
وقل لعبادي الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قل لعبادي إن كنتم حقا عبادا لله ماذا تصنعون. نعم.
And Allah orders this Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, "Say to my people that if you are my worshippers, meaning if you are truly my worshippers, then what should you say or do?"
وَقُلْ لِعِبَادِي يَقُولُ الَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ ولا حسن؟
أحسن.
هنا حسن. هنا أحسن. نعم.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he orders his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, say, O my Prophet, to the people that if you are truly my people, if you are truly my worshippers, then say that which is ahsan. Not really hasan, not really good, but ahsan ay, that which is better.
Naam. Mumkin a'la min bitter ay.
Yes.
Naam. Tamam. Kayf.
And how?
Kayf. يعني الكلام ستتكلم تكلم بأحسن شيء.
Speech, you're going to speak. So if you're going to speak anyway, then why don't you speak with that which is the best?
يعني هذا قل له لا تتكلم يا أخي. نعم.
Now, and for example, this brother now he says, but you told me don't speak.
يا أخي.
My brother.
My brother. تمام. لماذا؟ لما قل له يا أخي هو يحب هذا.
No. And why does he say يا أخي my brother? Because he knows that when you speak to somebody and you call that person my brother, he loves the friend.
لكن ما قل له لا تتكلم يا مشاعر.
And the Sheikh did not say to him don't speak or troublemaker. He said don't speak يا أخي my brother.
صحيح؟ يعني لأن الشيطان يريد أن يصنع فتنة. نعم.
Because الشيطان he wants to cause problems.
إذا تتكلم بأفضل كلام.
And therefore when you speak, use the best words and the best terms.
يا أخي.
My brother.
يا صديقي.
My friend.
يا أبا فلان.
أو أبو فلان أو أبو سان سو.
مفهوم؟
Understood?
تمام. نعم.
He enjoyed the good and forbid the evil, and yeah. He invite people to Islam. And he follows Sunnah in his daily life.
يزهد هذا في السنة صحيح أو لا؟
And you, so you find a new Muslim diligent and focused upon following the Sunnah, and that Muslim is trying to keep that person away from following the Sunnah.
السنة تصلح لبريطانيا أو لا؟
And the Sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, is it not appropriate to Britain?
في مشكلة؟
Is there any problem with this?
لا. تصلح لكل زمان لكل مكان.
The Sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, it remains appropriate and relevant to every time and every place.
فإذا أسلم إنسان.
So if a person accepts Islam.
يا أخي علم السنة.
Teach him the Sunnah.
لا يستطيع.
And if the person is not able.
قل الذي تستطيع افعل.
Teach him that which he is able to do so.
والذي لا تستطيع لا يكلفك الله.
And as for something which you don't have the ability to do, then Allah Subhanahu has not made you responsible.
أسلم.
So this person accepts Islam.
تقول الآن أنت مسلم.
You say to that person, now you're Muslim.
لازم تصوم. رمضان.
You have to begin fasting Ramadan.
لا يستطيع مريض.
If he says that he's not able to do so because he's ill,
سكر وضغط دم عنده.
If he has diabetes or blood pressure,
وقال الطبيب قال لي لا أستطيع أصوم.
And he says, look, the doctor told me that I'm not able to fast.
قل لا صوم ولو تموت.
Do you say to him, fast even if you die?
صح. لا. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. يقول لا ليس عليك صيام لكن تطعم.
If the new Muslim said, I'm not able to fast because of diabetes or blood pressure. You say to him, you have to fast even if you die. No. If the doctors have said this to him, then Allah subhanahu does not burden a soul more than it can bear. So you say to him that feed a poor person instead and you don't have to fast.
Now,
another trait of a Muslim?
Being forgiven.
Being forgiven?
Yeah.
تعفو الناس.
Huh?
العفو
هذه العفو اصبر انا افهم تمام عفو ايش هو
being forgiving and pardoning what the God is
لا بد في العفو من شرطين
in order to truly forgive and pardon a person you have to fulfill two conditions
الاول ان يراد بالعفو الاصلاح لا الافساد
firstly that your intent in forgiving and pardoning a person is to rectify and not cause more problems.
مثال.
An example.
يعني هذا الأخ.
This brother.
وجد واحد في بريطانيا يركب المتفجرات.
This brother, he found a person in Britain and he's manufacturing or making an explosive device.
يريد يفجر المساجد في بريطانيا.
And this person, he wants to blow up a mosque in Britain.
ماذا يصنع؟
What does he do?
قال اعفو عني.
If that person,
لا تقل لأحد.
If that person said to him, forgive me, pardon me, don't mention this to anybody else.
يعفو.
Should he pardon him?
لا. العفو عنه في إفساد.
No. Because pardoning him would cause more corruption, more damage.
لأن هذا يفسد على المسلمين هنا.
Because this person is intending to destroy and harm the Muslims.
هذا العفو لا يحبه الله.
So here we say that pardoning and forgiving in this situation is not beloved to Allah.
لازم يبلغ السلطات.
Rather, he has to be reported to the authorities.
إذا هذا الأول الشرط الأول للعفو.
So this is the first condition of forgiving and pardoning.
يراد به الإصلاح.
That you intend through this pardoning and forgiving to reform and rectify.
الشرط الثاني.
And then the second condition.
أن يكون العفو عن قدر.
Then you're forgiving and pardoning that person.
لا عجز.
You're forgiving and pardoning that person. Not because of your weakness and your inability, rather due to your ability.
تمام. معلش. هذا الآن. هذا.
أبو ثوبل الأزرق.
أي تخاصم مع هذا.
So this brother here, for example, this specific brother, he had an argument with that one.
تخاصم هذا ما شاء الله يلعب عندي.
And this brother he doesn't weightlifting.
فهذا ضعيف.
And this person. صغير.
نعم صغير.
He's young.
يقول لي هذا.
And the young brother says to him,
أنا عفوك عنك.
I'm forgiving you. I'm pardoning you.
هذا يقول لأنك ضعيف.
He says you're forgiving me, you're pardoning me because you're weak.
إذا لابد العفو يكون عن قدرة.
So therefore, pardoning and forgiving it has to be from somebody who has the ability to seek revenge and then he forgives.
الأب الآن.
The father, for example.
يعفو عن الولد.
He forgives and pardons his child.
يقول أنا أستطيع أضربك.
He says I am able to beat you.
لكن أنا أعفو عنك.
But I'm forgiving and pardoning you.
هذا عفو عن قدرة.
This is pardoning, meaning from strength, from ability.
مفهوم؟ هذا شروط العفو اثنين.
So these are the two conditions of forgiving and pardoning.
أن يراد به الإصلاح.
That firstly you intend something good, you intend to rectify.
وأن يكون عن قدرة.
And that you're pardoning. From being above it, that you have the ability to punish.
نعم. أخلاق المسلم.
From the manners and the qualities of a Muslim.
Honoring your guest.
إكرام الضيف.
أنا ضيف الآن عندكم.
I'm a guest.
نعم.
تفضل.
لا. ليس أتفضل على الطعام. لا. الضيف أنا ما جيت للطعام. نريد العلم، السماع. جوال لا هذا الضيف صحيح.
And I've come to you as a guest, but not to eat food. I've come to you as a guest, and your honoring me is that you're here to learn and study and not play with mobile phones and listen attentively.
نعم هذا كرم الضيف.
And this is the meaning of honoring the guest.
تمام إذا من أخلاق المسلم إكرام الضيف.
So from the mannerisms of a Muslim and the qualities of a Muslim is honoring his guest.
وهذا يختلف بالعرف.
And how to honor your guest, this differs according to your customs.
نعم بحسب عرف الناس.
According to the customs and the culture of the people.
قال هذا العرف عندنا كذا مثلا.
So for example, if the
ما لا يخالف الشرع.
If the culture of a particular person is that this is honoring their guest, as long as it does not oppose the Sharia.
نعم. إذا العرف معمول به ما لم يخالف الشرع.
So a person implements his culture and his customs as long as it does not oppose the Sharia.
قال نحن عندنا في الزواج.
If a person says that us when we marry,
لازم العريس يلبس لباس خاص.
The groom has to wear a particular type of clothing.
نقول اللباس هذا من ماذا؟ قل من قطن يصح ولا يصح هذا ما في مشكلة.
And as long as the clothing is permitted, like for example, if it's made from cotton, there's no problem with it.
قال لا يلبس حرير.
But if he said no, rather the groom has to wear clothing which is made from silk.
نقول لا حرام.
He said no, this is not allowed.
قال عندنا في العرف في العرس لا بد موسيقى أغاني.
And if a person said that from our culture and customs, that at the wedding there has to be music and singing.
نقول لا حرام. حتى لو كان العرف.
He said no, this is haram even if it's your culture.
قال العرف عندنا أن العريس وأبو العريس يقف ويستقبل الناس. ينتظر الناس.
And if a person says.
يسلم عليه. ما يجلس.
If a person said that from our culture and our customs is that the bride and the groom they have to welcome the guests and they have to greet the guests.
ولا يأكل.
And that they don't eat. They
don't حتى يأكل الضيوف. هكذا العرف يكون عندنا.
And they don't eat until all the guests have eaten.
نقول لا لا إشكال ما خالف شرع.
No.
نعم.
We say that there's nothing wrong with this. Meaning, if a person says that the culture in our weddings is that the bride or the groom, they have to receive the guests, they have to welcome the guests, they have to greet the guests, and they don't eat until the guests have eaten. We said there's nothing wrong with this. Yeah. Why? Because it's not opposed to Sharia.
يقول العرف عندنا ما يمكن نضع الطعام إلا مع الموز. نعم.
If a person says that our culture, our customs, is that we don't eat food without bananas.
نقول خلاص. Yes, sir. Yes.
We say that this is something which is allowed, permitted.
مفهوم؟ إذا العرف إذا لم يخالف الشرع لا إشكال فيه.
And therefore, if a person's culture and customs does not oppose the Sharia, then there's nothing wrong with this.
لكن لو خالف الشريعة ممنوع.
But if your culture or the customs of your people oppose and contradict the Sharia, then it is prevented.
نعم. من حسن إسلام المرء ترك ما لا يعني.
From the goodness of a person's Islam is to leave alone that which does not concern him.
كيف يعني؟
How is this?
يعني أدخل مسجد.
A person enters into the masjid, for example.
أقول لماذا الدواليب هنا وليست هنا؟
And a person says, why are the bookshelves over here? They should be over there.
هذا ليس عملك.
But this isn't your concern. This isn't your expertise.
هذا لا يعني.
Neither does it concern you.
اشتغل بما يعني.
you concentrate on that which benefits you.
يتكلم في العلماء.
A person speaks regarding the scholars.
أنت عالم؟
Are you a scholar?
عالم؟
Are you a scholar?
لا. إذا هو لا يعرف العلماء.
You're not a scholar, and therefore you don't know the scholars.
طيب هذا الآن لو يتكلم في الأطباء نسمح له؟
If this ordinary person, if he was to speak regarding the doctors, would we listen to him?
لا.
No.
لأنه ليس بالطبيب.
Why? Because he himself is not a qualified doctor.
أما العلماء قد تكلم ما في مشكلة.
As for the ulama of Islam, speak about them and there's no limit.
لا. من حسن إسلام المرء ترك ما لا علم.
Rather, from the goodness of a person's Islam is to leave alone that which is not concerning.
السياسة.
Also speaking about politics.
بريطانيا.
British politics.
حكومة.
Their government.
لا يعني.
It doesn't concern you.
لماذا؟
Why?
رزقك بيد من؟
Because your risk, your provisions are in the hands of who?
بيد من؟
الله.
ها؟
الله رزق.
حكومة؟ لا. بيد الله. سياسة أنت ليس لك علاقة بالسياسة.
Your risk is in the hands of Allah. As for politics, you are no concern with politics.
يتكلم سياسة أوكرانيا وش؟ في المسجد أيضا.
A person while sitting in the masjid, all of his speeches about Ukraine and the government and politics.
في موريتانيا.
In Mauritania.
في إمام مسجد.
There is an imam of a masjid.
هذا لا تكلم في السياسة في. نعم مفهوم.
And this imam of the masjid, he doesn't speak about politics and these affairs.
يتكلم فقط في العلم في القرآن في السنة فقط.
He speaks regarding knowledge and Quran and Sunnah only.
يعني لو تكلمه تقول السياسة أوكرانيا حرب لا يسمع هو لا يسمع.
And if you try speaking to him and you say, for example, the war in Ukraine, he won't listen.
من حسن إسلام المرء. ما يعني سياسة.
And he'll say that from the goodness of a person's Islam is to leave on that which is not concerned with. The one you Ukraine does not concern me.
الإمام لا يحب المؤذن لا يحب الإمام لا يحب لأنه لا يتكلم.
And the مؤذن of this masjid he doesn't like the imam. Why? Because the imam doesn't speak well.
لا يتكلم بالسياسة.
So the مؤذن does not like the imam because the imam doesn't speak about politics.
يو حدث انقلاب على رئيس موريتانيا قبل 6 أعوام تقريبا حدث انقلاب على الرئيس نعم
and 6 years ago in Mauritania there was a revolution or a rebellion a coup against the leader
فقال المؤذن اليوم أتكلم مع الإمام في السياسة
so the مؤذن said that today because of the rebellion against the ruler of Mauritania today I'm going to speak to him about politics
قال الإمام اليوم حدث انقلاب على رئيس موريتانيا
and the مؤذن said to the imam that today there's been a rebellion against the ruler of Mauritania
ما التفت مشى
and the imam didn't even turn towards him carried him walking
لماذا
why
من حسن الإسلام ما تركوا منه
Because from the goodness of a person's Islam is to leave alone that which is not concerned.
يقول المؤذن بعد سنتين.
And the مؤذن said.
من هذا الموقف بعد سنتين.
The مؤذن said that 2 years later, meaning 2 years later after I tried to speak to him.
الإمام يعني كان ذاك اليوم يعني يريد يتكلم قليل.
On that day, 2 years later, the Imam wanted to speak a little bit.
قال بسرعة ما حدث عليه انقلاب.
And The Imam said to him, well, they've gone quickly. Tell me what happened that day about the rebellion.
خليك في حالك. خليك في علم أحسن.
The Mu'adjin said, stick to knowledge is better.
والله لو اشتغلنا بالعلم اشتغلنا بما خلقنا لأجله ارتحنا.
By Allah, if we were to occupy our times with speaking about knowledge, we would be speaking about that which we were created for and we would be at peace.
يدخل المسجد.
A person enters the masjid.
وقال للمؤذن.
And a person says to the مؤذن.
أقم الصلاة.
Establish the prayer.
رجل عادي.
Just a common person orders the مؤذن to establish the prayer.
كثير يسمع الآن يدخل. صح.
Many people they now enter. Look at their watches. Time to stand up. Give the adhan.
المؤذن ذكي.
The مؤذن is intelligent.
ما تكلم معه.
And the Mu'adhin did not reply to him.
أقام الصلاة.
The Mu'adhin stood up and he began the Iqamah.
وصلى المؤذن.
And the Mu'adhin prayed.
انتهت الصلاة.
The prayer finished.
خرج هذا الرجل.
And the man left.
خرج المؤذن.
The Mu'adhin followed him.
وأمسك.
And the Muaddin held him.
كيف الأخبار؟
The Muaddin said to the man, how are you?
إيش صار في أوكرانيا؟
What's happened in Ukraine?
وقعد يتكلم معه.
And the Muaddin began talking with him.
بعدين قال له كم نتكلم الآن؟ كم لنا وقت؟
And then the Muaddin said to him, how long has it been since we've been talking?
يعني ربع ساعة 20 دقيقة.
And the man replied, it's been 15-20 minutes now we're talking.
قال ما تخاف الله ما استطعت تصبر في المسجد دقيقتين وهنا 20 دقيقة في الخارج الدنيا.
And the Muaddin said to him, do you not fear Allah? When it came to the salah, you couldn't be patient for 2 minutes. But now when it comes to speaking about the dunya for 20 minutes, you're willing to sit and speak?
يدخل المسجد.
So a man enters the masjid.
وإيش يسمع؟
What does he do?
Telephone.
Begins with his telephone.
Bismillah. YouTube. Telegram. صح؟ صح أم لا؟
Correct or not?
داخل لأين أنت؟ دخلت مع كوفي هنا ولا إيه؟
What have you entered? Have you entered into a cafe?
ها؟ عين. لأنه ممكن يدخل كافي وينظر كوفي ونائم صح يلعب في الجوع يقول هذا ايش؟ هذا كوفي.
Maybe a non-Muslim will enter into a masjid, sees this one sleeping, that one drinking, that one eating, this one playing on the phone. What will he think? That this is a masjid or a cafe?
لكن لو دخل.
But if that non-Muslim entered into the masjid,
وجد هذا يصلي.
And he found this one praying salah.
وهذا يقرأ القرآن.
This one reciting Quran.
وهذا يسمع على شيء.
And this one reciting to
his شيء. وهذا يدرس حديث.
And another one studying hadith.
إيش يقول؟
What would he say?
يقول أريد الإسلام.
He'll say, I want this Islam.
صح. إذا المسجد ليس لهذه الأشياء.
So the masjid is not for these things.
من حسن إسلام المرء.
From the goodness of a person's Islam is to leave alone that which is not concerning.
نعم.
المسلم لا يؤذي جار.
الجيران ثلاثة.
There are three types of neighbors.
جار مسلم قريب.
A neighbor who is a Muslim and is a relative.
له حقوق ثلاثة.
And this type of neighbor has three rights on a person.
حق الإسلام وحق الجوار وحق القرار.
He has the right of being a neighbor, and he has the right of being a Muslim, and he has the right of being a relative to him.
الثاني جار مسلم.
And then you have a second type of neighbor, and he's a Muslim neighbor.
له حقين حق الإسلام وحق الجوار.
And he has two rights upon you. The right of being a neighbor and the right of being a Muslim.
الثالث جار كافر.
And then there's a third type of neighbor and that is a non-Muslim neighbor.
حق الجوار.
And he still has a right upon you and that is the right of being a neighbor.
لا تؤذيه.
You are not allowed to irritate him.
تدعو للإسلام.
You have to call him to Islam.
تهديه تأليفا لقلبه عن الإسلام.
You can give him a gift to bring his heart closer to Islam.
نعم. نعم بر الوالدين.
Also obedience to parents.
ولو كفار. نعم ولو كفار.
Whether they are كفار or not, you have to obey your parents.
صلة الأرحام ولو كفار.
Also keeping the ties of kinship with your relatives even if they are كفار.
نعم تحبهم محبة طبيعية.
And also that you love your parents and your relatives who are non-Muslims with them, that's a form of love.
وتبغض ما فيهم من كفر.
But at the same time, you despise and dislike the actions of kufr which they are
doing. تدعوهم للإسلام.
You call them to Islam.
لكن ما تشاركهم في عائلة احتفالات.
But at the same time, you don't partake in their festivals and their celebrations.
تنصح لهم.
You are truthful in your advice to
them. تعاملهم كما عمل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الكفار بحسن الخلق.
And you live and interact with the non-Muslims as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did in his time.
Abu Talib kafir, يقول له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, يا عم.
Abu Talib, who is a non-Muslim, yet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to address him, oh my beloved uncle.
حتى يدخل في الإسلام.
So that he's invited and attracted to Islam.
Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام يقول لأبي كافر, يقول يا أبتي, يا أبتي, يا أبتي. نعم.
Ibrahim عليه السلام, he would say to his father, and his father was a non-Muslim, he would say, Ya Abati, O my beloved father, O my beloved father.
نعم.
being humble and its opposite is being arrogant and haughty.
من تواضع لله يرفعه.
And whoever humbles himself for the sake of Allah, Allah will honor and elevate him.
بعض الناس يتكبر.
Some people they act and behave in an arrogant manner.
العرب يتكبر على غير العرب.
You find that the Arab behaving arrogantly with a non-Arab.
لا لا فضل لعربي على غير عربي إلا بتقوى الله.
But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said there is no virtue for an Arab over a non-Arab except by the taqwa, by piety.
حتى الكبير يعني لا يضرب الصغير.
And similarly, an older person should not hurt a younger person.
لا تترفع على الناس.
Don't behave arrogantly or think you are better than people.
نعم المتكبر نسعاف السلام يوم القيامة يكون كذاب الناس تطعهم بأرجلهم هذا عقوبة المتكبر.
And the punishment of the one who was arrogant in this worldly life is that in the hereafter he will be so insignificant that people will trample over that person.
طيب هل من التكبر أن كان الإنسان لباسه حسن؟
And when we say that you should not be proud or arrogant, does that mean that you don't wear clothes which are nice and you take pride in your appearance?
قال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام لا.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said this is not from arrogance.
التكبر هو رد الحق.
Rather, arrogance is defined as stubbornly rejecting truth.
نقول لهذا يا أخي لا تتكلم في الدرس.
So if we say to a brother, oh my brother, do not speak in the lesson.
قال لا امشي.
And then the person, well, I'm not attending, I'm leaving.
متكبر.
This shows arrogance.
لكن قلنا لا تتكلم في الدرس يا أخي.
But if we say to that person, my brother, don't talk in the lesson.
قال آسف.
And he said, I'm sorry.
هذا ليس متكبر.
Then this is not arrogance.
وغمط الناس يعني ظلم الناس.
And so the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he defined تكبر arrogance, he said, it is to reject the truth and to belittle the people.
لا تظلم.
Meaning oppressing people. As a Muslim, you should not oppress.
No. حسن الظن يقول.
He said, حسن الظن.
يعني ما عنده سوء ظن.
Meaning that you do not behave suspiciously, you do not think suspiciously of others.
يعني هذا اشترى سيارة بورش.
For example, this brother,
2022,
he purchased a Porsche which is from this year, 2022.
هذا يقول من أين؟
And that brother says to him, where have you bought this car from?
Yes, sir.
Are you stealing?
هذا سوء ظن.
This is سُوءَ الظن.
الأصل إحسان الظن في المسلم.
And the base ruling is by default that you always give your Muslim brother the benefit of the doubt.
يعني ما تسيء الظن في أخيك المسلم.
Meaning you don't have suspicions regarding your Muslim.
كما تحب أن الناس يحسنوا الظن فيك تحسن الظن في الناس.
And just as you would like others to have good thoughts about you, then you have to have good thoughts about others.
بعض الناس لا يوجد لديه إلا سوء ظن.
Some people, they have nothing with them except suspicions.
صحيح؟ يفتش.
Always wanting to check and investigate. With a microscope.
لا. هذا يصلي ويسحب الجوال ويفتش فيه.
No. Checking people's mobile phones.
وفي البيت ينظر وكذا.
And also looking to the houses of people.
ويسمع.
Trying to listen.
يضع كاميرا مراقبة.
Eavesdropping. Security cameras.
يجوز.
Is any of this allowed?
في الشريعة.
In the Islamic Sharia.
إذا إنسان ينظر هكذا من البيت تأخذ عود وتفقع عينه. عين.
Islamic Sharia. If نعم. A person looks through your keyhole, poke him.
حتى زوجته.
Even your wife.
ليس لك أن تأخذ الهاتف وتفتش.
Even your wife is not permitted for you to begin investigating her phone.
تقول لها.
Rather say to her.
أنا لا أراقبك. الله يراقبك. أنا أثق فيك.
Say to her that I'm not here to inspect you. Rather Allah Subhanahu is looking over everybody. I trust you.
خلاص.
And leave it at that.
مفهوم؟ تضع كاميرا في البيت في المطبخ.
As for placing cameras in the house in the kitchen.
يصح. يقول ها صنعت الطعام. يتصل عليها. يقول صنعت الطعام.
Like for example, a person rings his wife, says, "Is the food ready?"
قالت نعم.
And she says yes.
قال تكذبني أنا أراك أنا ما
أسمع. She says you're lying because I can see you still cooking.
لا يجوز.
This is not allowed.
حتى ولو كان لأقرب الناس إليك.
Even if this is towards those people who are closest to you.
هذا جاء لزيارة هذا.
If one brother came to visit another.
ماذا يصنع؟
What does he do?
آداب الزيارة.
So these are not the etiquettes of visiting somebody.
لا بد يستأذن قبل الدخول.
First, he has to seek permission before entering.
يفتح الباب يدخل.
As for opening the door and entering immediately.
ما يجوز.
This is not allowed.
حتى ولو كان هذا عزوبي غير متزوج.
Even if the person he is visiting is single and not married.
مفهوم؟ ماذا يصنع؟
So how should he behave?
يدق الباب.
When he comes, he knocks on the door.
كم مرة؟
How many times?
مرات.
ها؟ ثلاث مرات.
Three times he knocks on the door and seeks permission.
فقط.
Three times only.
يدق بحجر.
And does he knock on the door with a stone?
بقوة.
Or with banging?
ها؟ لا.
No.
العرف متعارف. جرس موجود. أول ما يدق بيده. نعم.
نعم. He rings the bell or with his hands.
أما يدق بقوة.
As for banging the door down,
لا يجوز.
This is not allowed.
أو
a person says,
السلام عليكم. أدخل.
Or a person can say and seek permission, saying, السلام عليكم. Should I enter?
هذا يقول أنا أعرف 100% أن هذا داخل البيت.
And if a person says, but I know 100% that this person is at home.
أعرف.
I know.
أنا رأيته داخل.
I saw him entering.
ثلاث مرات لا يعود.
And three times the person is not responding to me.
نقول نعم ثلاث مرات هذا الآن يريدك تنصرف أفضل لك أن تنصرف ما تبقى مفهوم نعم هذا قيل لكم ارجعوا فارجعوا نعم.
And if this person after three times and you know he's in the house and he doesn't answer you, it's because for whatever reason he doesn't want you to enter and this is better for you not to enter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the meaning of which is that if it is said to you, return, then return. As for looking,
يجوز؟
لا.
لا يجوز.
It's not allowed.
طيب فتح له هذا قال ادخل.
Next, if the person said to him, if the person opened the door and said to him, come in.
ما أين يدخل؟
Where does he enter? Which room does he enter?
هذا يفتش كل البيت.
This one he begins to check every single room.
لا.
No.
أين أجلس؟ قال هنا. تجلس.
If he asks the guest where should I sit, he says sit here.
ما يستطيع يخرج إلا يأذن له هذا بالخروج.
And also when it comes to leaving the house, he does not leave the house without his permission.
لا يجلس أمام الباب.
And also a person should not sit in front of the door.
لأنه ينظر أمام الباب.
Always looking at who's coming and going.
مفهوم؟ لا تجلس أمام الباب، تجلس هنا أو هنا أو هنا في ظهر الباب.
So sit towards the side or with your back against the door.
تجلس.
When you sit down.
إيش تقول؟
What do you say?
ها؟ تفتش.
Do you begin investigating, checking?
أي شيء موجود تفتش في البيت.
صح؟ Anything you can find, you try to analyze it.
يصح؟ لا يصح.
This is not allowed.
ولا يمكن تسأل عن أشياء.
And also, you should not be questioning him regarding matters.
يعني تقول له زوجتك جميلة.
يعني private matters. You should not ask him whether his wife is beautiful.
كم تعطيها من نقود؟
How much money do you give her?
كم راتبك أنت؟ كم راتبك؟
What's your wage?
كم عندك في البنك؟
How much money do you have saved in the bank?
يصح.
This is not correct.
يصح. من حسن إسلام المرء ترك ما لا يعني.
From the goodness of a person's Islam is to leave alone that which is not concerning.
مفهوم؟
Understood?
فإذا قال لك واحد كم عندك في البنك؟
So if a person says to you how much money do you have saved in the bank؟
ادعو الله لي.
Say supplicate for me. Supplicate for me.
الله أعلم.
Allah knows best.
مفهوم؟ نعم. لا تقرأ.
That terrible.
لا تغضب.
Also, not becoming angry.
من أخلاق المسلم لا تغضب.
From the mannerisms of a Muslim is not to become angry.
هذا يقول اعطينا الهاتف.
If this one said, give me your phone.
أخذ.
And the person said, take my phone.
أخذ. لا تغضب.
Don't become angry.
يقول لا تغضب.
Do not become angry.
مفهوم؟ تمام. آداب زيارة المريض.
Also, when it comes to the etiquette of visiting the ill.
كيف يزور المريض؟
How does a person visit a sick person?
لا بد يستأذن.
First of all, seeking permission.
يتصل عليه أو على أخيه أو كذا حتى يستأذن في الدخول للزيارة.
First, you ring him or you ring his relative to seek permission to visit.
يأتي في وقت الزيارة، لا يأتي في وقت الطعام، في وقت الدواء.
And also, that you choose an appropriate time to visit him. Meaning, you shouldn't visit him whilst he's eating or whilst he's taking his medicine.
يقول أحسن وقت بعد الظهر.
If a person says the best time is to come after dhuhr. Why? Because people are eating lunch.
لا، ما تأتي في هذا الوقت.
Now, don't visit him during that time when he's eating.
تدخل عليه.
Secondly, when you enter upon the ill person,
دقيقتين أو ثلاث دقائق فقط.
Two or three minutes, a few minutes you sit with him and you talk to him and visit him.
السلام عليكم لا بأس طهور. نعم.
السلام عليكم make دعاء for him.
وكل خير. الله يكتب لك الأجر. مثلا.
And trying to make him feel better. Everything's okay. Allah will reward you.
نعم. كم بعض الناس يدخل على المريض.
Some people they go to visit an ill person.
قال أنت مسكين.
They say, oh, you're so poor, you're so wretched.
والله ما تستاهل. لا تستحق هذا والله.
You're not deserving of being ill.
والله أنا قلبي يتقطع عليك والله. قلبي يتقطع عليك. كيف يتقطع عليك؟ قلبي لا فيه.
Says my heart feels for you, feeling bad for you.
أنا أبكي عليك.
I am cry for your sake.
لكن أنت تعرف هذا البلد.
But you know this country.
تموت.
You're gonna die.
أنا أعرف. ونحن في هذا البلد هكذا. حتى لو تموت ممكن في المحرقة يحرقوك ما تجد قبر هنا ما في.
And he says, you know, you're gonna die, and you know in this country, even if you die, they're not gonna bury you, they're gonna cremate you and burn your ashes.
صحيح ولا؟ في ناس تزور مريض يصنعوا هذا أو لا؟
There are some people who visit ill people like this.
كان يقول اعترف عن قضاء القدر اكفر بالله والله.
It's as if that person through his pessimistic speech towards this person is telling him to be discontent with the decree of Allah and disbelief.
لا تذكر عند المريض الموت.
So when you go to visit an ill person, you don't mention death.
لا تقنط برحمة الله.
And you don't make him lose hope in the mercy of Allah.
طيب يموت إنسان.
And then if a person dies,
ماذا نصنع؟
What should we do?
ماذا؟ يجتمع كل العائلة من كل البلدان، صح؟
Nowadays, when a person dies, what happens? All the families from all the various towns in the country that come together in his house.
رحمه الله حبيبك صديقه رحمه الله أخينا.
And they say this was a brother of mine. He was beloved to me. He was such a good friend. And may Allah have mercy upon him.
ما اتصل عليه يوم لا يتصل عليه يوم لكن عندما مات أخي حبيبي هو لا يكلم أصلاً.
When he was alive, you never rang him for a single day. You never even spoke about him. Now that he's died, he's become your brother all of a sudden.
الآن أصبح صديقك وقريبك.
Now he's your friend. Now he's your relative.
وأين غدا؟
And then you start asking about lunch.
يجلس ثلاثة أيام غداء عشاء إفطار موز كل شيء.
And those people who come to the house of the deceased for a full 3 days, they'll be in the house eating breakfast, lunch, dinner, bananas, everything.
ويتكلموا في السياسة في نعم.
And whilst they're sitting there, all of their speeches about politics.
رحمه الله.
May Allah have mercy on
هذا كبائر.
So this is from the major sins.
كبائر الذنوب.
This is from the most major sins.
مات إنسان.
If a person dies,
تعال عند القبور عزي وامشي.
Come to the graveyard, give your condolences and leave.
أو تأتي عند البيت السلام عليكم عظم الله أجرك وامشي.
Or you come.
تبقى تجلس كبيرة.
Or you come to the door. You give the condolences. Ask for congregating and sitting. This is from the
Majesty. It just ارسل رسالة.
You can ring him. You can send him a text message.
هذا بدعة.
And this is from the innovations.
اجتماع بدعة.
Congregating like this is from the innovations.
لابد أننا لقال لا هم ما يأتوا بيتي ما يأتوا البيت الحمد لله لا يخربوا البيت الحمد لله ما يأتوا البيت.
A person says that I found a way out of this.
إذا مات الإنسان يقول ما يأتوا بيتي الحمد لله ما يخربوا البيت.
And what they say is if somebody dies don't come to my house. I don't want you to spoil or damage my house.
أين يأتوا؟
So where should we go and congregate?
مسجد.
Come to the masjid.
مسجد هنا. طعام شراب الناس تأتي ما في مشكلة صح؟
Don't come to my house because you might damage my house. But go to the masjid, eat, drink, gathering.
تأتي في المسجد.
Condolences in the masjid.
يدفنوا في المسجد.
Being buried in the masjid.
نعم. ما يدفن في بيتي لكن يدفن في المسجد.
Not in the house but in the masjid.
كل شيء في المسجد.
Everything in the masjid.
هذه بيوت من؟
These mosques are the houses of whom?
Allah. كيف تتعدى عليها؟
These are the houses of Allah. How can a person spoil and violate the house of Allah?
هل تريد مسجد نظيف؟
Do you like and do you want a masjid to be clean?
لا يريد بيت نظيف. أما المسجد لا مشكلة.
A person, he likes for his house to remain clean, but as for the masjid, it doesn't matter.
نعم. والله أعلم. صلى الله على نبينا محمد وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خيرا. بعد العصر إن شاء الله نكمل. إن
شاء الله.
ثلاث ساعات.
The next lesson.
لا وقع العصر الشيخ تقريبا ثلاث ساعات.
ثلاث
ساعات. ثلاث ساعتين. نعم. ساعتين. ممكن نأخذ ربع ساعة الشيخ أو ثلاث ساعة ونرجع إن شاء الله.
لا بعد العصر.
بعد العصر كثير شيخ. ساعتين بعد العصر.
ساعتين إذا نأخذ أسئلة وبعد العصر. نعم. ها. سؤال أنا كوس.
متى العصر؟
نعم متى العصر؟
خمسة.
يلا. وانت قاعد.
أمشاركم فيكم سؤالكم. قلتم يعني مراتب
المحرمات أربعة.
ما الضابط يعني كي نفرق ما بين الصغيرة والكبيرة والشخص؟ هل هو ضابط يعني نفرق بين؟
في ضابط. ارجع إلى شرح الدروس المهمة بالعربي بالإنجليزي يجب إن شاء الله. مو هذا. شرح الدروس المهمة باللغة العربية والإنجليزية تكتب هيثم سرحان. .com ولا السرحان .com تجد كتاب موجود فرق بين صغار وكبر وشركة أو شركة صغار ودورة سليستر ذكرنا فيها فيديوهات أيضا موجودة خلاص؟ تمام أتريد بعد الدرس أعطيك لينك أعطيك لينك هذا لا يحتاج ترجمة إلا أنت تترجم له
The brother mentioned what's the difference between knowing a minor sin from a major sin from minor sheikh to major sheikh and the sheikh replied that if you go to his website which is sarhan.com or even if you search on Google Haytham Sarhan, his website will come up and the explanation to this book at the Durus Muhimma is on the website and all of this is detailed or if you go to the YouTube channel of Mr. Sunay Nelson, the recent Dora that we did in there we also went through lessons where we differentiated between the different types of sins.
Tamam. Now.
Can you explain the situation regarding the congregation of the funeral? Obviously, as men we go to the janazah, we go to the funeral. But the women, what's the ruling about that? Because I hear sometimes.
Are women allowed to visit the graves?
No, not the graves, they congregate in the houses. So, give taxi, for example.
هل يجوزكم النساء أن يجتمعن؟
لا نساء ولا رجال. ما يجتمعن. نعم.
Men and women should not gather.
لا.
No, I mean like women gathering together.
ولا women ولا man. لا اجتماع. نعم. كل تعزية نياحة.
نعم. Because this form of gathering and giving condolences is from نياحة.
طيب. نعم.
شيخ can you explain us the right تعزية in Islam?
Can you write?
لا لا صحيح.
Explain us.
How to
The Sheikh said
تصلي عليه تصلي عليه.
First of all, you pray صلاة الجنازة
وتتبع للقبر
and then you follow the procession to the graveyard
تستقبل القبلة
You face the Qibla.
تدعو لهم بالتثبيت.
You make dua for Allah to make it firm.
أقرباء.
And then the relatives are there.
تعسيهم.
You go to them, you give them a condolence.
هناك أو غير هناك، لكن لا تجتمع، تتصل أو ترسل رسالة فقط. حتى لو جاء البيت دقيقة دقيقتين يمشي ما يجلس. هذا الصحيح.
And you ring the person, you send the person a message. Even if that person came to your house and sat in the house for a few minutes, that's okay. But then he leaves after that.
من هذا أفضل أو النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So this man of congregating and staying in the house for a long while, is this better? It is what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did better.
اجتمع النساء لموت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
الرجال.
When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قرأ القرآن. قرأ سورة ياسين.
When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم died. Did the women congregate? Did the men congregate? Did they used to recite Quran? Did they recite Surah Yasin?
صنع الطعام.
Did they used to prepare food for people?
من أفضل؟
So who is better?
إذا لا أسمع. مفهوم؟ نعم. تريد تتصدق تصدق هناك. مو تتصدق على هؤلاء. مفهوم؟ مو تتصدق على آياته قال أنا أصنع طعام صدقة هنا صدقة هناك للفقراء المساكين مو لهؤلاء.
And even when it comes to giving charity, making food, give it to the poor.
طيب. نعم.
In general question.
لا. One question only. نعم.
شيخ بارك الله فيكم لو تشرح.
لا أنت عايز
موش. مسمى الإيمان مثلا بعض التفصيل مثلا عند أهل السنة والجماعة مثلا قول القلب وعمل القلب.
يقول ما هو الإيمان عند أهل السنة والجماعة سواء يجعلني وياكم منهم ما هو الإيمان؟
The brother asks, what is إيمان according to the people of the Sunnah? May Allah make us and you from them.
الإيمان هو قول باللسان.
إيمان is a statement on the tongue.
كان يقول لا إله إلا الله. آمنت بالله.
Like when a person says لا إله إلا الله or when a person says I have إيمان in Allah.
وهذا يعتقد بقلبه.
And also having a firm belief in your heart.
ويعمل بقلبه وبجوارحه يصلي يصوم يخاف يتوكل.
And also actions of the heart and actions of the limb, of the limbs like fasting, praying. This is actions of the limbs. And also fearing Allah, having reliance upon Allah. These are actions of the heart.
الإيمان يزيد وينقص.
And also iman increases and decreases.
نعم. أركان الإيمان ستة.
And the pillars of iman are six.
نعم.
أن
تؤمن بالله.
That you have iman in Allah.
وملائكته.
And his angels.
وكتبه.
And his books.
ورسله.
His messengers.
واليوم الآخر.
The final day.
والإيمان بالقرار ربه.
And having iman in the decree of Allah.
نعم.
الشيخ.
لا.
لا في هذا.
لا. سؤال واحد يغضب علينا هذا بعدين هذا عدل سؤال واحد
question he said one question
البعث بعد الموت إنهم يقولون السبعة بعد العلماء هنا في هذا المكان
العلماء على رأسي كل العلماء على رأسي لكن الكتاب والسنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول أركان الإيمان ستة نحن نقول ستة مفهوم ما نسب العلماء نقول على رأسي نعم لكن ستة Now,
all the ulama we respect them, but Allah and His Messenger mentioned to us that there are six pillars of iman. We don't insult the scholars, but Allah and His Messenger mentioned six pillars of iman.
تمام؟ نعم. هذا سؤالنا لا. نعم.
شوف, how do you achieve خشوع من الصلاة? How do you achieve خشوع من الصلاة? How do you achieve خشوع من الصلاة?
يقول كيف أخشع في صلاتي?
How do I attain خشوع in salah?
Sunnah. تتعلم كيف صلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
First of all, following the Sunnah, learning how the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to pray.
تدخل للصلاة. هذا أكبر مشكلة للخشوع. وضع الطيران.
And when you enter into salah, your biggest problem in salah is this. So when you enter into salah, pray on flight mode.
أو ضعف السيارة.
Or leave your phone in the car.
مفهوم؟ تمام. لا يكون شيء يشغلك.
Also, nothing should distract you. in your salah.
سجادة على زخارف تلفاز يلعب كورة وأنت تصلي هنا.
The television is on while you're praying. Your prayer mat is adorned with flowers and patterns. They're playing football whilst you're praying.
التنويع في الأذكار هذا يجعلك تخشع.
And also saying the different adhkar in the salah. This also helps you to concentrate and have khushu.
يعني ليس دائما الفاتحة قولها الله واحد. لا.
Meaning every rak'ah you shouldn't recite surah al-Fatiha and surah al-Ikhlas. قل هو الله
أحد. مفهوم؟ فاتحة بعدين قل هو الله أحد. قل أعوذ برب الفلق. قل أعوذ برب الناس. هكذا. نعم.
And so reciting surah al-Fatiha. And then alternating between different surahs and ayahs.
سجود مرة تقول سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمد ومرة تقول سبحان ربي الأعلى بعدها تقول مثلا سبوح وقدوس رب الملك توبه.
And also when it comes to the sujood, and alternating between the various adhkar and remembrances in the sujood.
تنظر إلى موضع السجود لا تلتفت.
And also looking down and where you prostrate and not looking around.
تتذكر أنك عندما تصلي أنت تقابل الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And also remembering that when you are praying salah, you are standing in front of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
وأنت تصلي جاءك الشيطان.
And if you are praying and shaitan comes to you.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
And then you're allowed to seek refuge in Allah from shaitan and blow towards your left hand side three times.
تدعو الله أن يرزقك الخشوع في الصلاة.
And also supplicating to Allah, asking Him that He bestows upon you خشوع in صلاة.
تمام؟ نعم.
السلام عليكم. I want to ask if someone wants to recite Surah Fatiha, so Surah Ikhlas in every Salah or Rak'ah, how do you do it? You recite this Surah and then recite
هو يسأل عن سورة الفاتحة إنه دائما يجعلها آخر قراءة.
سورة الإخلاص.
أعرف الإخلاص.
سورة الإخلاص في كل ركعة كيف؟ يعني هل
لا ليس السنة إنه تكون في كل ركعة. نعم.
It isn't the sunnah that سورة الإخلاص should be recited in every single ركعة.
لا. لكن لو فعلها إنسان نقول هذا حسن لكن السنة أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يغير بين السور ليس دائما الإخلاص لكن هذا فعلها صحابي وأقره النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So the sunnah, نعم. What the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did is that he used to alternate between the various سور chapters. This is what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم do. Yes, a companion did it once and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم accepted it from him. But the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to alternate between different surah.
مفهوم؟ نعم.
How do you achieve sincerity?
إخلاص تدرس التوحيد.
So you attain sincerity by firstly studying tawhid.
حتى تعمل به.
And you study Tawheed to implement Tawheed.
تدرس الشرك حتى لا تقع فيه لأن الشرك يهدم الإخلاص.
And also you study shirk so you can avoid shirk because shirk it destroys إخلاص.
تحرص أن العمل تعمله لا يعرف به أحد إلا الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And also try your best that any good action which you do, only Allah knows about it.
تدعو الله أن يرزقك إخلاص.
And also supplicating to Allah that Allah bestows upon you sincerity.
لا يلبس عليك الشيطان أن تقول أنت غير مخلص.
And don't allow Shaytan to deceive you that you're not being sincere.
لأن الشيطان ما يحب أهل الإخلاص.
Because Shaytan, he does not love the people of إخلاص.
فيقول أنت غير مخلص.
So he says to you that you're insincere.
اترك العبادة.
You're being insincere in your ibadah, so leave this ibadah.
لا تسمع.
So you don't listen to him.
قل أنا أطلب من الكريم سبحانه وتعالى لا يردني الله.
What you say is that I am asking the one who is kind and Allah does not refuse me.
تمام.
السؤال لا يتعلق بدرس يتعلق بالهجرة. يعني نسمع أن الهجرة واجبة على هذه الأمة، وسمعت أن إذا استطاع الشخص أن يظهر الدين لا يجب هذا. وهل
يقول ما حكم الهجرة من بلد الكفر إلى بلد الإسلام؟
The brother asks the question, what is the ruling of making hijrah from the non-Muslim countries to the Muslim countries?
واجب.
It's an obligation.
قال أنا لا أستطيع.
But he says I'm not able to do so.
لماذا تسأل؟ لماذا أسأل إذا لا أستطيع؟
If you're not able to make hijrah, then why are you asking?
نعم. طيب. إذا تبقى هنا تدعو إلى الله وتصبح المجتمع الحمد لله، وإلا امشي آخر إذا لم تهاجر. فأنت غير نيتك الآن أن تبقى هنا للدعوة إلى الله حقا لإصلاح المجتمع. نعم.
If you are here and you're calling to Allah and you're reforming society, you're rectifying society, you're working for the betterment of society, alhamdulillah. And if you're here and you're not doing any of this, then you're sinning. So right now, change your intention that you only remain here so you truly call to Allah.
نعم. تستطيع تدعو إلى الله.
You're able to call to Allah.
لكن WhatsApp.
But this doesn't mean what
time. لا. هذا ما هو دعوة.
This isn't دعوة.
لا. دعوة إلى الله تتعلم.
دعوة to Allah means learning.
وتعلم الناس.
Teaching the people.
تدعو غير المسلمين.
Calling the non-Muslims.
ومطويات.
Giving out leaflets.
بعض الكتب، بعض المقاطع المفيدة.
Giving out books, sending out beneficial.
كل يوم تعلم.
Every single day, try to do something.
نعم. نكتفي. إن شاء الله بعد العصر. معلش. اللي ما يجي معك تعال معك.
طيب.
بعد العصر إن شاء الله نعوض هذا الحس.
إن شاء الله the next lesson we'll have after عصر.
إن شاء الله. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى لنا ولكم التوفيق والسداد، والله أعلم، وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم، وجزاكم الله خيرا.
كلهم بعد العصر إن شاء الله.
نعم. The next lesson will be after the عصر إن شاء الله.
Yeah. 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 Ye